Hey, what's up, YouTube? I don't know if I'm ready for this. I don't know if you're ready for this. I'm pretty sure I'm not. Look at these dudes. Slayer. Slayer. Heavy metal music is a mountain of metal with many sub-genres. Slayer has been at the top of this mountain forever. I'd say since before this record, Rain and Blood. They started in 1984. The four guys, these same four guys, got together in like the LA area, which is weird to me because LA is sunny and I think you kind of need to have bad, challenging things around you to create this kind of metal. Like sunny and nice doesn't work. It worked for them. They started in 84, did a couple self-produced records and an EP. They went out on tour on their own in Tom Araya's Camaro with a trailer, and these four guys sitting in it. Oh, that poor Camaro. And then Rick Rubin picked him up. He saw, which is genius of him, and put him in the studio, and they did Rain and Blood, which is just like a half an hour of this band about an inch away from your nose the entire time. And that's where Slayer resides. They reside about an inch away from your nose, sometimes a little closer, never any further than one inch. They are just relentless, brutal, heavy metal, completely unique. They started out with punk influences at the time, punk rock, but same for me, punk rock for me led to metal, because metal was like punk rock with dudes that can play. And the drummer on this, what's his name? Not Tom Araya. Oh, wow, how about that for drawing a blank? I've been practicing and I don't know what's going on with my head anymore. I have to look. Are you still there? What's wrong with me? That's embarrassing, but I'm not starting over. But he is so super great. See this ride cymbal? He owns that ride cymbal 16th note beat. He owns it. He's like a lead, he plays lead drums. Just, you can call it overplaying. I wouldn't. He's like just driving this metal band. This Wicked 2 guitar attack with Jeff Hanneman. Rest in peace, bro. And Kerry King. Kerry King is like just completely heavy metal. I love Slayer. They never disappoint. And they've never done a song like Nothing Else Matters. Or like The Unforgiven. Or Enter Sandman, for that matter. They're here. This is where I live, an inch away from your face. So I've been practicing this. Here's how I do this. I choose the song, and then I listen to the song over and over and over again everywhere. Listening to it in a different way than I normally would when I'm just rocking out to a tune. I start to listen to every detail and kind of drill it into my head. And then I start to practice it over and over. Sometimes not too much. This I kind of did to the point where I just have to go for it. I'm not 100%, but I'm ready to share with you. Oh, what's the beer? Mountain Ale from the Shed Brewery. It says here, a local legend steeped in Vermont lore. Lore? Were you really steeped in Vermont lore? It's got 7.4 alcohol. That's kind of high for a beer. And has 35 IBUs. If you know what an IBU is, drop a comment. And it says Rugged Brown Ale. Rugged. Rugged is the reason why I stopped watching Yellowstone. Every scene and everybody in that show has to just be like rugged 100% of the times. I like to get rugged, but I have a softer side too. Like, I'll chop wood. I'll chop wood, I'll dig a hole. So we're gonna do South of Heaven, not South of Heaven, Mandatory Suicide off of South of Heaven. Mandatory Suicide is a song about being sent off to war. Mandatory Suicide. Everyone's dying. At least like 50% of them are. And, oh man, the pharmaceutical company, what'd they want me to say? Oh yes. So I think it's called Sorrento or Sorenzo. For occasional and explosive diarrhea. Stop it in its tracks and save your pants with Sorenzo. All right, if you know the song, sing along. This song is so heavy, like every other Slayer song. And this on this record, they kind of slowed down, which is when I was able to grasp them. A Rain and Blood, they were just like a million miles an hour. I was like, what is happening? Until the breakdown and Angel of Death came up, and you're like going, oh, that's what's happening. So with this record, they pulled back a little bit. They were less thrashy speed metal, got more of a groove happening. And that's when I was like, man, that is cool. And at this time I was taking lessons from a teacher named Jamie Peterson. And I'd bring this record in and say, hey man, can you show me this? Show me this beat. Can you show me this? And he'd like write it out and show me stuff. So that was cool. Thanks, Jamie Peterson. All right, man. Freaking Mandatory Suicide, Massacre on the Front Lines. It starts right in. Oh, and when I was practicing, I broke a drum head. I broke this snare drum head. These Aquarian high energy heads, I found them to be indestructible, but this one was destroyed. But it broke at the weak part. This stuff here, it'll never ever break. So I had a spare old one, I put that one on, same one. Enough of that. Enough of that, I know. I know you're sick of it. I'm sick of it. You're sick of it, I'm sick of it. We'll be right back. Okay, man. The Shed Brewery, Mountain Ale. Rugged. Slayer. I love you, Slayer. Good night, Slayer. Good night, everybody. Oh, and it's kind of fitting I did Slayer. Yesterday was Good Friday. Tomorrow's Easter Sunday. I just learned that today is called Holy Saturday. Like, Holy Saturday! Huh? So happy Holy Saturday. Stupid thing.